Hey everybody, Christopher Odd here. Welcome back to Dragon Age Inquisition. We're in the hinterlands. We have a couple of things that we could be doing. I'd like to speak with Dennett to see if we could get some horses. Potentially closing some fade rifts. Ideally, they're on the way to Dennett. We've got some camps to establish. We have one. And then there's a field tent requisition in which we need lamb's wool and silk. So, I am going to head towards Dennett. But we'll talk to the people that can give us some other quests before we head out.
You there? Can you help my wife? Please, I beg you.
Can you tell me what's going on?
What's wrong with your wife?
She gets sick when the weather's foul. Can't catch her breath, like cobwebs in her lungs. Our son Hindle makes a potion that lets her breathe. He's the only one who can make it, but he's joined that cult in the hills.
Oh,
please,
really?
Get to him and tell him what's wrong. Without that potion, she'll die.
Interesting. Get the potion from the refugee's son. So we're going to have to convince him. And if he's in a cult, I'm sure he's pretty short-sighted.
That's the last of the bread. Going to be a long, hungry night.
That is a very interesting place for you to be keeping warm.
These people need food. There are rams out in the hills. Good eating. Cooks easy. No lords around to kill you for poaching. Too dangerous to go hunting now. More likely to find mages than luck. Good luck. Luck won't go fat on your ribs.
So ram meat. So these are kind of some of the more like fetchy quests, like typical MMO stuff, but if they happen, they happen. I'm not too enthused on just running out to make them happen. But don't get me wrong, if there's rams in my path, they won't be for long.
Full of villages. Where are their coats?
People are cold?
What do you need to keep these refugees warm? Blankets, warm clothes, all of it. These poor sods lost everything when the mages and the Templars went crazy. If we were in a village, I could just pinch a blanket off a clothesline and be fine. Out here, I'm sure the apostates have plenty of supplies, just haven't been able to find them.
Farewell.
Fancy you.
Find 5 apostate caches. I don't believe that that's going to be easy. Holding the hinterlands, the threat remains. Okay, so it's actually does a pretty good job of keeping us in tune with where we need to be going. The only problem is that, like, it's way out here, but we may discover a few things on our way, so I am going to take that trip. What is going on here? Toy soldier. Oh, wow. Okay.
Kill that warrior.
All right, you guys ready? Go. I'll wait till I can arc lightning him. There we go. Oh, she's not done. Okay.
Look at this. The apostates have gone mad with power.
The Templars aren't looking any better here.
I imagine that we might find some of those caches here. This guy is gonna give me trouble here. I'm gonna have to try flanking him.
We should move on. We can only restore order by securing an alliance.
A hand hammer mace? Somebody might be able to use that. I would really like if we were to loot something, if it would just run us over there to do it. Who could potentially use this longsword? Perhaps Cassandra? Yeah, it's better than the Inquisition longsword that she has. I like that this one does a guard damage bonus as well. Let's actually give her the hand hammer. Oh, level 4. Is there a way that I can... Oh yeah, requirement level 4 right there. So for now, we'll go with the Ferelden Captain's longsword. For her. And you know what? Just in order to kind of keep things fresh, it might be fun to kind of cycle through here from time to time. Oh, okay. Audith's leveled up. Let's do that, actually, right now. So I guess we scale somewhat differently. Some features on this screen are currently unavailable. Why is that? Is that because we're, like, in battle or something? You know what? We might have... Here we go. Okay, is everybody cool? There we go. Alright. So we can continue down the storm path if we'd like to, and I kind of would like to. Lightning bolt, you summon a bolt of lightning that blasts and paralyzes a single target. If other enemies are nearby, the bolt will paralyze the target for longer. 2 seconds per enemy nearby. That's massive. Grabbing it. Okay, so that one, we'll have to make sure that we target it a bit differently. The way somebody explained it in the comments, I thought it was really smart, is how you essentially have like 4 different classes that you can play. Which is really cool and can keep things fresh if you find yourself getting... Oh, we need that silk, actually. That's good. We need lamb's wool. What is this thing? Okay, guys, we got more out here. That long shot's pretty powerful.
I do not believe these are simply bandits. Their armor and training suggest something deeper.
Hey, we've got witchwood. What is this? Okay, we've got something we can read here. Ferelden longsword, an exacting longbow. Vera could be the only one that would use that, and since we're going to continue using his current weapon, we're not going to move on to that. Stronghold of the Apostate Mages. Search Witchwood for the Apostate Stronghold. Are you tired of letting the witless fools bind you with their fear? Come to the Witchwood. Follow the signs. We will be free to work our craft, free to become the new gods we have always known we truly are. That's interesting, if not somewhat creepy. If we set this as active, let's see where this is. Oh, it's just anywhere. Okay, so it won't actually lead us right to it. Which I actually kind of prefer. We might as well grab all these things. We're gonna need them. This. Defeat demons to close rift. Okay, let's switch back to us. Whoa. Prepare prepare for next- Oh, are you kidding me? Let's get in closer. Whoa, they can come out of anywhere! Oh! He's immune to that, too. There we go. Let's close this thing. There we go. So we need to close two of those, if I'm not mistaken. Okay, those are not... That's not one that we needed, I guess. We gained some power from doing so, which is great because that'll help us scout out new areas. Spirit essence. Alright, let's switch back to him for a second. Oh, everybody got some levels here. Okay, good. So, let's go... And let's invest, shall we? We went into archery already, which I think is pretty good. I'd like to have like some really powerful areas before we branch out too far. Death from above. That one's very situational. That's the only downside. What other options do we have? We've got sabotage because we have caltrops and we have an advanced version of caltrops as well. The worst mistake your enemies can make is to let you see them flinch. Whenever you score a critical hit, you regenerate stamina. That's pretty good. Maybe we go poison. Do some damage over time. Cassandra. I think if we continue down this path, it's pretty good. Using techniques perfected by Elysian Chevaliers, you can't be flanked. Gaining stamina when you lose health. Could be pretty good. Let's actually grab that. And then our mage. So this is all about protection. Spring to the place when you are okay, spring to the place around you automatically when you're badly injured. That could be a lifesaver. Enemies less likely to attack you in battle even when you damage them. Threat reduction. Okay, I like that. Let's put the heat on the others. Because he is a little bit squishier. Okay, so our mage went down. Just when I was hoping he wouldn't. Are you kidding? Maybe try to stay out of trouble next time. Let's actually, we'll control him for a bit. Walk a mile in his shoes. Okay, we've got some silk. Area of effect attacks. So, area of effect attacks allow you to target groups of enemies. Use the mouse to position the AoE. Left click to initiate the AoE when you're happy with its position, or right click to cancel. Oh, okay. So what is this one? Let's right click to cancel it. Just so that I can understand his things a few more, or a little bit better. Create a shimmering protective barrier that acts as temporary additional health. Okay, so we'd want to target ourselves with that then. I love that ice damage that we can do. That's crazy. The thing is, we have three people that are experienced with range, and well, okay, cool. And being able to switch between them during combat could be awesome, actually. We're getting a little bit off pace for Dennett here, but I love that when he's paralyzed, we can still damage him, too. Weapon fragments. This is a creature research item. Interesting. And look how far the arc lightning goes, too. That guy was way back in the back there. Okay, let's carry on. I'm a little bit worried about this stronghold here. Like, with his ice and our paralyzing shock, we can kind of hold them back quite a bit. Oh, what? It's clear. Hey, here's lamb's wool. Four of them, too. Perfect. And that'll be all we need. Okay, Fort Connor was constructed by a young Arl Eamon after the Orlesians were driven from Ferelden. It was named in honor of Eamon's father, who died at the Battle of Westhill, after whom the Arl named his son. Eamon was determined for Redcliffe to stand as a shining example of Ferelden's strength. He constructed Fort Connor to watch the King's Highway and protect the Hinterlands against all enemies. It proved its fortitude against Darkspawn during the Fifth Blight, suffering damage only when the Darkspawn deployed emissaries. Eamon was said proudly at the time that Fort Connor was unbreakable by anything short of magic. And for that, thank the Maker, we have Templars. Okay. So now, does that count as... There's a situation where... Maybe in the Hinterlands here? Yeah, camps established. No, okay, so this doesn't count as establishing a camp. It's just finding a new area. Landmarks discovered. Okay. So that's what that is. Free March's helmet. I did switch on the setting that lets us not have to wear the helmet. Because they're kind of goofy, but... I mean... my character kind of looks a bit goofy, too. I can't really... complain. Let's see. Might as well wear a helmet. Let's give him a helmet as well, if possible. He's level 6, or... you can just take this one. Templar encampment. Brothers, we must listen to the call of the Maker himself, who has given us the duty to destroy these mages. By their rebellion, they have forfeited their right to live. They are not people, and any order that asks us to end this just and righteous battle is a lie. A test sent by him to separate the faithful from the foolish. Join us off the West Road and fight for a worthy cause. Okay. That's interesting to, like, they explicitly say they are not people. Okay, so looks like we're gonna have to continue going around. Templar encampment, we must be ready to fight not only with the mages, but those who sympathize with them. Have not the mages blood magic to trick the minds of the unwary? Are not most people, as we know them, sheep ready to be led by those who speak with authority? The people must be protected from the mages. It is our right and our duty. But those who supply them with lyrium, those who offer them comfort and food, those who shirk their duty to supply us for our worthy fight, they are sympathizers who have lain with demons and can breed only abominations, and they must be slain as such. We will wage our war from our camp off the West Road. We will not stop until the world is clean. It's really interesting to hear their opinions, and we know they're harsh. Okay. I'm getting kind of hammered here because I'm the only one up front. Beautiful. Now we have all the lambs we'll ever need. Orlesian Lion Shield. Awesome. Level 8. So can't use it yet, but that is pretty nice. So we should be able to give that to Cassandra. She is level 4, right, okay. So a little bit of time. Looks like another landmark here. Broken Bridge. This bridge is broken recently, most likely in fighting between apostate mages and renegade Templars. But it's important because it does bridge the gap to where we need to go. Gold jewelry and a letter. A letter found on a dead body. Return the stolen treasure to the Western Fortress. Take it back, take it back, take it back. Dreams won't stop until you take it back to the Western Fortress. They will never stop. You will wake up screaming and find notes written by your own sleeping hand. Take it back, or I will draw allies to do it for me. Strange small item found on the body. That's super bizarre. A letter found on a dead dwarf. I don't care how many demons and apostates are in that area. The package was lost somewhere on the river north of those farms. Follow the river and find it, or we'll find you. Okay. So we have no shortage of things to look for, that's for sure. Oh, are we gonna have to... Yeah. Not me. He's just frozen in place.
No normal wolf would fight with such determination.
The breach may have driven them mad. Or perhaps a demon took command of the pack.
I was gonna say, is there a reason that they're so hostile, but... That explains it. Okay, so we're close. Let's see if we can go inside here. Okay, Soldier's Nemesis, it's a rare bow, level 7. Restriction not Varric and Rogue only, so... I imagine we're gonna pick up other people down the road... ...that can use these weapons that we're finding. But also, like, I don't know if we should... I guess some of the common ones we could sell? What is going on? What is this? Look. How do we get up there? I'm really intrigued. I want to figure that out, but we might have to go around. Okay, when the compass pulses, press V. Oh, cool. Searching indicates the direction of hidden objects with an additional pulse on the ground. If you're close enough, reveals them.
We should look around.
And that kind of gives us... Oh, no, this isn't going to be it. I'm guessing it's going to lead us right to Dennett, but... And it kind of gives us... A direction, like it's back there where I assume Dennett is.
This must be Master Dennett.
Okay, let's talk to her first.
You'll be wanting to speak with my husband.
Oh, you're the wife, okay. Okay, so now we scan this. It's locked. Oh no, don't shoot, don't shoot. I don't want to set anybody off here. Okay, so we must just not have access yet. Let's talk to Dennett, perhaps that is the key.
So you're the Inquisition, eh? Here you're trying to bring order back. It's high time someone did. Watch yourself, Inquisition. It's ugly out there.
Where is this leading us? Is it just leading us to him? I'm not even sure anymore. maybe it's underneath here? Very strange. Let's talk to him and see if it goes away.
Name's Dennett. I served Arleman for 30 years as horsemaster. I hear your Inquisition is looking for mounts.
That we are.
It is. Can you help us?
Not at the moment. I can't just send 100 of the finest horses in Ferelden down the road like you send a letter. Every bandit between here and Haven would be on them like flies on crap. You'll have mounts once I know they won't end up as a cold winter's breakfast.
Okay, so how do I prove that to you?
If you have a problem with me personally, I'd like to know about it.
What? This because I called you a Haller rider? Those Haller are damn majestic beasts. I'll give my right arm to ride one. My wife Elena manages the farms and Bron's in charge of my guards. They'll tell you what they need. Until then, you deserve something better than whatever knock-kneed plowneck they gave you. The chestnut over there is a purebred Ferelden Forder. Take care of him, and he'll take care of you, Inquisition.
Okay, cool. So we need to speak with Bron, Farmland Security. It's super weird that... The scan is kind of taking us all over the place. Banner from Kirkwall. Hard in Hightown, Chapter 1. This is the book that Varric wrote that he was joking about earlier. That's cool. They say coin never sleeps, but anyone who's walked the patrol of Hightown Market at midnight might disagree. The pickpockets and confidence men head to the taverns at dusk. The dwarven businessmen and nobles go back to their tiny places to fret... or tiny palaces to fret over the ways they got cheated, and the market falls silent. Donin Brenikovich knew every angle of the market with his eyes closed. 20 years of patrols had etched into him so that he walked that beat even in his dreams. The recruit, Jevlin, was another story. The ring of steel striking stone told Donin that the kid had stumbled onto a column again. Into a column again. His new armor would be full of dents by sunrise. Torches would make this easier. The sound of Jevlin hauling himself off the pavement was like a tinker's cart crashing. Torches make you night blind. You'll adjust. Donin crossed the square to help the kid to his feet. A breeze scurried across the plaza, sending the banners and pennants shivering and carrying an old familiar scent. Donin stopped in his tracks. Something's wrong. His voice was low. Warning. He peered into the dark up at the mezzanine just above them. Follow me. Be ready for trouble. The two guards climbed the dark stairs and there, in a puddle of shadow, found the body. Gold trim, satin glittered through the blood. Get the captain, Don inside. We've got a dead magistrate. Is this fiction? Maybe it's outside somewhere, but it could be just behind the building somehow. We'll go and investigate. But we're going to take a little break here. When we come back, we will mount the horse at the stables. But we'll talk to the people around here as well. We've got a new quest here, Trouble with Wolves. And I believe he said we could talk to Bron? Ask Elena how to make the farm safe. Maybe we just help her with that since we are taking their horses. Search the river for the package. There's a lot of things we can do here. Here, Bron. Bron believes building a series of watchtowers in the area would warn farmers and refugees of incoming attacks. So, let's see where he is really quick. Yeah, he's pretty close. So, thank you guys. We'll see you very soon. Take care.